Hey guys, it's Michael. The US has reported more than 74,300 new virus cases on Monday this week, pushing the country's daily average over the past week above 71,000 new cases, which is the most in any 7-day stretch of the pandemic. And now a number of cities and states are starting to put more restrictions into place and shutting down certain businesses. So in today's video, we're gonna go over exactly what is going on with the increase in cases and the increase in hospitalizations. And after that, we're gonna go over new restrictions that are being put in place. And if you enjoy this sort of content, well then please be sure to like the video down below and subscribe to my channel. It really helps out a lot. So the US reported more than 74,000 new cases of the virus yesterday on Monday. And now the country's daily average over the past 7 days is above 71,000 new cases, which is the highest the 7-day average has been in any 7-day stretch during the pandemic. The 7-day average is up more than 19% compared to a week ago, and it hit another all-time record on Monday as 36 states reported worrying rises in the number of hospitalized patients. The average number of hospitalized patients with the virus over the past 7 days rose by at least 5% in 36 states as well. Hospitalizations typically lag behind the number of cases as it takes time for people to get diagnosed and become sick enough to require medical attention. However, scientists point to hospitalizations as a more telling indicator of how the country is doing because they said if more people get tested, there'll probably be more people who test positive, but really to see how the country is doing will depend on how many people actually have to be hospitalized to be treated for the virus. Moving on, in Illinois, where the governor announced new business restrictions last week in 4 separate counties, and Chicago had 2,638 people who were hospitalized with the virus as of Monday. Illinois governor said that there seems to be a virus storm on the rise and we have to get prepared, which is why he has imposed new restrictions on businesses in much of the state as cases have surged to record levels. In addition to this, in Texas, the El Paso County judge issued a curfew on Sunday to protect overwhelmed and exhausted hospitals and workers. Things are getting significantly worse, and these restrictions are starting to be seen all across the country as things are starting to get significantly worse, and the average number of hospitalized patients over the past 7 days declined by 5% or more in only 4 states in the entire US. And these 4 states that have seen a decrease is Alaska, Hawaii, Kansas, and Maine. Scientists are saying that this is a sign of things to come moving into the winter, and that they think hospitals are going to be very, very stressed in the coming months. And finally, the US is not the only country seeing this dramatic increase and worsening of the outbreak, as the virus is surging across much of Europe as well. The World Health Organization warned on Monday that some countries might need to implement severe business restrictions again to take the heat out of their outbreaks. And Dr. Mike Ryan, executive director of the WHO's Health Emergencies Program, said during a news conference at the agency's Geneva headquarters that we're well behind the virus right now, and that in order to get ahead, it may require sacrifices for many, many people in terms of their personal lives and new restrictions being put into place. So anyways, that's what's going on with the virus. Cases are increasing all across the country and new restrictions are being put into place. But I hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Don't forget to get your 2 free stocks valued up to $1,600 when you download the Webull investing app using the link down below. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you next time.